a message through your respective forum to all the listeners, to all the viewers, that let's follow China's path where we should not have any enemy and we should have friends. And of course, we should keep our close friends closer.
Okay.
And we should keep our far friends even closer.
And what is the message for the Western world? Because
for the West,
they are warriors and they were killing people and they take out the civilization and impose the civilization. But China, on the other hand, is not doing that thing. They're developing the third world country into a first world and they're not disturbing their civilization. So what China vision is, what actually they want?
Actually, as you see and as you may have read in the history books, that Asia was always on top of everything when it came to the global market, being the market hub of global commodities and products. So I think that China is actually doing the whole Asian continent a favor in uplifting all its allies, its neighbors, and connecting the old Silk Road through its Belt and Road
Initiative.
Yeah,
Obor, yeah. So, that's right.
Through the Belt and Road
Initiative. So what is the future of Pakistan now? What do you think?
I believe Pakistan's future is as bright as the new star of 2022. And I believe that the days of sorrows have long gone. And
But when the question is this, Mr. Yazid, when is the poor man get being changed, you know? I don't want to listen to the stories. The rich people are getting rich because I'm a left-wing guy. I open it straight to the people. I eat, I don't save, and I work for the welfare of the society. But when I see the people, they're using the slogan of China, but on the other hand, they're doing corruptions. You know, I'm a forensic accountant being trained from England. And I do what I can do. You see, I can't cross my lines because I work in my circle. So when I see Pakistan, that people are doing still crime, corruptions, that how can we take advice from the China to come and stop this nonsense in my country?
Well, you see, there is an old English saying that opportunities give birth. To fraud.
Okay.
I might have not stated it correctly, but you know, the crux of the
matter
is
this. Yeah,
that's the thing is that, you know, of course, we do need to learn a lot from China when it comes to their anti-corruption, when it comes to the poverty.